Friends, welcome to my channel. First of all, I will request you to please subscribe my channel. Today we will be discussing about camshaft chain tightening. Now, as you can see here, this is the arrangement for camshaft chain. This is the crankshaft and this one is the camshaft. This is the tension arm. And this whole arrangement, this is called chain tensioner. And here we can see here that nut 1 is there, nut 2 is there, and a spring is there, and nut 3 and nut 4 is there. Now, this part, the side view of this this part, I'm going to show you here. This is the side view. Now, as you can see, this is the chain tensioning bolt. This is the chain tensioning bolt. Here chain tightening bolt is there. So this chain tightening bolt is, it's passing through this one. This is the shaft actually. The shaft front view, it looks like this, and the side view is like this. Now, first of all, what we have to do is we will loosen nut 4 first. First we will loosen this nut 4. Then we will loosen this nut 1. After that, we will lose nut 3. This one, nut 3. And after that, we will lose this nut 2. Then after that, we are going to measure the free length of this spring. The free length of this spring. Now, we will see on every ship, you will find on every main engine, the spring is having a plate. On that plate, some details are mentioned, some specifications are mentioned. The specifications are the free length of the spring. For in this case, it is 188.5 mm, and the reduced length of the spring. After compression, we will get 168 mm. The reduction means the compression. The reduction what we get in the length is 20.5 mm. It is 20.5 mm. This is 20.5 mm. This is the important reading. We have to maintain this this reading. Now suppose after we have loosened every nuts accordingly in a particular sequence as it has been mentioned, what happens is that we will measure the free length, and the free length is lesser. Like earlier, for a new spring, the free length is 188.5, but suppose now it becomes 187. Now, if it becomes 187, what we will do is that we have to again we have to tighten in such an extent that nut 3 has to be tightened to such an extent that the whole compression, the reduced length, will be 20.5. This 20.5, we have to get this 20.5. Now this is 166.5 mm. For when, if suppose this is 187 mm, if for an old spring the free length gets reduced to 187 mm, then we have to tighten to this compression. The after tightening, the length of the spring should be this much, 166.5. with the caliper we will measure it, and after that the tightening sequence will be as such. Now one thing we have to note, we have to take care of, is that during tightening, engine should be turned slowly in that direction, such that slackness is towards chain tightener. Now this is the chain tightener what I mentioned earlier. The slackness, it has to be maintained. The engine slowly through the turning gear has to be turn in such a direction that the slackness should be towards the chain tensioner. Okay, now tighten nut 2. This is the nut 2, we'll tighten first. After tightening nut 3, the new length we will measure, which will become 166.5, and after that we will tighten nut 3. Then after that we will tighten nut 2, then we will tighten nut 1, and finally nut 4. So this is all about, my friends. In next video, we will be talking about the adjustment of camshaft chain after chain tightening. Please subscribe to my video, please.